Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Agilent Technologies. Today we're going to look at two different methods for protecting our DUT when using a power supply. We're going to set a current limit. In the first method, we're going to switch from having the power supply be a constant voltage source to a constant current source. In the second method, we'll use the overcurrent protection method. So let's get started. We'll go ahead and set up a current limit, such that when the limit is exceeded, the power supply will switch from being a constant voltage source to a constant current source. So I've set the limit at 20 milliamps. So now we'll go ahead and we'll increase the voltage to our DUT. And as we increase the voltage, it will start to pull some current. At this point, you'll see that the power supply is a constant voltage source. So whatever voltage we program it for, that's the voltage that's outputting. And as we increase it, now you can see it switched to being a constant current source. So we can no longer increase or decrease the voltage. The power supply just stays as a constant current source. If we do decrease the voltage enough that the current drops below the limit, it'll go back into being a constant voltage source. In addition to that is if we remove our DUT, and we program it for a higher voltage, say 3 volts. When we go ahead and connect our DUT, the power supply instantly goes into the constant current mode. So it'll just toggle back and forth as the DUT is connected and disconnected. Moving on to the second method, we're gonna use the overcurrent protection. So from the front panel, I can only set a level of 100 milliamps or more. So I've gone ahead and programmed the overcurrent limit from the PC, and I can store it as a state and recall it at any time. So I've gone ahead and programmed the overcurrent for 20 milliamps. The next thing is we need to turn it on. So now with the overcurrent turned on, we'll go ahead and increase the voltage of our DUT and see what happens. So as we increase it, it starts to pull some current. And you can see the power supply is operating as a constant voltage source. And then once it's exceeded the 20 milliamps, the overcurrent protection gets tripped. At this point in time, the output has been set to 0. And even if we remove the DUT and so the condition's no longer there, it still stays at 0. So in order to use the output again, what we have to do is we have to clear the condition. So I'm going to go ahead and recall our stored state, which sets up the power supply for a lower voltage. And then I'm going to go ahead and clear this condition. So I go to overcurrent and clear. Okay, overcurrent, clear. Okay, now the output is enabled again, and we can increase our voltage. And as long as our current doesn't exceed our over current condition, it will continue to operate as a constant voltage source. So at this point in time, you can see some of the differences between using the overcurrent condition and the setting a limit and switching between constant voltage and constant current. So if you're programming, we'll take a look at what that looks like really quickly. Is that the one thing you can do is in your program is you can actually query the status registers to see what state or if there's a change of state in the power supply. So I wrote two programs. One uses the first method to switch between constant voltage and constant current. And so in the program, it starts off and all the measurements are in the constant voltage until we exceed our 20 milliamp limit and the power supply switches to the constant current mode. In our second program, we're going to use the overcurrent protection mechanism. And as we run the program, the power supply stays in the constant voltage mode until we exceed the 20 milliamps and switches to the overcurrent protection. And once that happens, the output drops to 0, and will stay there until we clear that condition. And so we're able to tell what mode the power supply is in or when the mode changed by looking at the status register and querying it after each time we set the output of the power supply. So we looked at a couple different methods for protecting our DUT. We set a current limit and had the power supply switch from being a constant voltage source to a constant current source. And the second method, we went ahead and set the overcurrent protection so that when the power supply output more than 20 milliamps, it just shut down the output until we went ahead and cleared that condition and cleared the overcurrent protection. So hope you found that interesting. Thanks for watching.